whiplash, considering how the game ended. Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Klonoa Door to Phantomile. In the last part, we beat the game and I had to beat the game again 100% so I can get to this again. This is the world map. This pretty much only shows up, I think, after you beat the game. It shows how many of the prisoners you've rescued and such. But for getting all 72, you get the extra stage, and for being the extra stage, you get the music player. I'll go over the music player first, though. It's fairly basic. You select it, you can play any of the music that tracks are in the game. And it actually shows you which stage they're played in, too. They do loop a bit, but it is an overall relay mode, so after a while, it will switch to their next track. So if you ever want to listen to this game's kick-ass music, just leave the game on this, and you'll hear it all eventually. But that's not the big reason you're here, I can already tell. See, Klonoa is infamous for its extra stage because it's actually kind of really hard. Considering how easy the game is, let's check it out to see how bad it really is. With a loading screen we haven't seen since like part one. Where are we? It's Baloo's tower! He actually finished it!
Wait a little bit more for me, my love. Way! Oof!
Hey! What happened?
Enough! A brat like you wanted my darling in the face. Dirty Canavan traitor!
What? Wait just a minute!
Don't think you're special just because you rescued Lafice. Lafice was saved because of my love for her.
Right.
So I'll gladly hand over the title of Phantomile here to you. In exchange, Lafice is mine!
What the?
Actually, Lafice is already up there. So, you kids should go home and take a nap. This tower's off limits to you. So long.
Hey, wait a second. Well now, let's get going. First off, favorite stage theme in the game by far. I love this track. And hello, a lot of extra lives. Yeah, as you can see, my live count's a bit high because I actually practiced this stage off screen because this stage is hard. It's all about really precise timing with your wind bullet and the double jumps. You'll see it as we go through. Though I'm not going to be paying attention to much things aside from this beginning part here. First off, there is a timer. This game, it is kind of a speedrun thing. This is something that I actually bring back for all the stages in the remake. It does actually time even on your first playthrough. And it's not that hard of a stage to once you get down to it, but... Well, not, no, I should say it's not that hard of a stage to speedrun once you get down to it, because there's instant death everywhere. If that makes grammatical sense, if you know what I mean. Now, the big thing with this stage is that you're supposed to get a reward for doing the hardest thing that any stage has in this game, getting 150 gems in. Which I do. I do get the best gem count. But for some reason, the reward didn't load for me. What's supposed to be is a bunch of fireworks in the background of the cutscene at the end of it that are in the shape of things that we've seen throughout the game. But nope, it didn't happen. Oh well. Now, doing the 150 gems thing, you can do it in any of the stages. In fact, it's the maximum you can get. And for doing it on the world map screen, above and below the 1112, blah blah blah, the gem will turn into a blue gem. If you do 130, it turns into a green gem. So while I'm doing this challenge to get 150 gems, I might as well go over the remake differences again. Big differences in the remake include difficulty, first off. Klonoa, as you may have noticed, isn't a very hard game to begin with. I only died twice in the playthrough. But the remake version is actually easier because it gives you more health, 10 hits as opposed to the original 3 to 6, depending on how much damage you take. And your attacks have a longer range, and Klonoa has the stupid wind move, which I mentioned a couple of times, where you shake the nunchuck, he makes wind go all around him, and enemies are slowed down. Replay value, which the original has obviously the unlockable sound test and extra level that we're playing right now, but the remake has both of those, as well as a bonus challenger for every level, which gives you a medal for the character viewer, extra costumes, which you'll see on screen in a moment, which are his costume in the remake, his costume from Klonoa 1, his costume from Lonate's Veil, which is the blue one, and a random summer outfit. In fact, Klonoa as a whole looks a lot older in the remake. There's also the character viewer, which you get to look at all the character models in, which is cool enough, I suppose. Then there's the voice acting, which, as you may have noticed, the Klonoa games all have a made-up language, which is called Phantomile. However, the remake has English, French, Japanese, and some others for the European version languages for voice acting. However, very often it's hit or miss. In fact, most people hate the English voices, myself included, though I actually do find some of them funny, at least. Thankfully, if you hate the voice acting in the remake, you can in fact turn on the Phantomile language, though it's a re-recordings of them. And then there's aesthetics. The original game looks and presents itself great, do not get me wrong, but the remake looks amazing. But the biggest problem to me is Klonoa's height, as I mentioned earlier. Due to that, some things in the script don't match up, specifically when some characters refer to Klonoa as a kid, including his own kind, the Breezy Galians, or however the hell you pronounce that, like his grandfather, because he's as tall as any adult, even though he's supposed to be like 7. That's mostly just an annoyance at first, though it becomes a pretty glaring oversight late in the game. Overall, if you want more bang for your buck, the Wii version's the way to go, but if you want the story the way it's supposed to be, then get the PlayStation version. Also, high random music glitch where it's playing one of the boss themes. Or you could be the smart one and get the Wii version. Then after you beat it, look up the original cutscenes on YouTube. And also, seriously, if you guys can find Lunatay's Veil on the PlayStation 2 one, play it. It's so good. But yeah, this is a kind of a boring bonus stage. There's the timer, obviously, which if you're going for speedruns is, I suppose, helpful. Actually, it's pretty sad, but did I mention, I forget if I already mentioned this, but the remake also has a boss battle time trial mode, level time trial mode, and so on and so forth, and also reverse levels mode, which is pretty cool. Actually, the challenge rooms in the remake are very similar to this. There's lava on the ground that you have to avoid, and you just have to get to the end to get to the medals, which I believe unlock the character model viewer stuff. I forget, honestly. Either way, we're at the end of the level. Booyah. We made it! So where's Baloo and Lafice? I love you. Like a big brother. Oh my god. Baloo! We didn't have to rush after all. He's too old for her. But he's young at heart. Lafice! I guess it's pointless to ask if you're alright. Thank you, Klonoa and Hupo. I'm sorry you've had to come all the way up here. It's alright. Sorry we weren't helpful. Oh, I'm sorry I caused you trouble. Baloo should have known much better. But, you know, Baloo is really kind. Here, he gave me this. This is where you get the music player if you haven't beaten the music stage already. Or the extra stage already, rather. In both versions. What's this? A machine? Baloo made it specially for me. It's a strange box that plays music. Really? Let me hear! Okay, you do this here? It's around now that the bonus for getting 150 gems would kick in. There'd be fireworks in the shape of things we've seen throughout the game. Oh my god, Baloo, I love you. He's my second favorite character in the game next to Soliel. Though mind you, the characters in this game are rather tropish, but they're still great. Love that. But yeah, that's the extra stage, and this is also how you save the game. You would usually do this after every level if you have started to save at the beginning of the game, but I forgot to do that like the dumb shit I am. But yeah, that's Klonoa Door to Phantomile pretty much in its entirety. I'm not going to go for 150 gems in every level because that just takes too long. It's pointless in the end anyway. I recommend it. It's a pretty fun game. Thank you guys for watching, and now I'll see you guys either tomorrow or Monday for the replay of Mega Man 03, because that's when that's gonna start. I can't wait!